get out there.
Always say yes. Never eat lunch alone. Sell.
Hi, I'm Maura Aarons-Mele, and I'm the author of Hiding in the Bathroom, an introvert's roadmap to getting out there when you'd rather stay home. I'm really excited to share both my personal, sometimes painful, and definitely humbling journey as an ambitious and anxious introvert, and to give you, hopefully, strategies and skills to create the kind of success that's right for you and allows you to fulfill your dream. I think the thing that's really hard when you're in an office culture or a working relationship where you've got someone who wants more meetings, more FaceTime, more socializing, more getting out there, and then you have another person, Melissa, it sounds like you and definitely like me, who wants to have a 10-minute conversation and then maybe go think and come back with an answer, right? Maybe we don't want to work on the fly. Maybe we don't want to sit for hours working together, is to establish rapport and establish confidence. And then it's okay to set ground rules. You know, it's okay actually maybe to say, I'd love some time to think about this. Do you mind if I put my thoughts together and come back to you? That's something I've actually had to learn how to say to clients. And when I would first say that, I'd feel, oh God, they think I'm dumb or they think I don't know what I'm talking about. But it's actually a great rule in negotiating. You know, there's a rule in negotiating that says don't anchor yourself. Never say the first number if you're, you know, selling a house or whatever. And you can think about it like that. It's always okay to take a moment and say, you know what, I'd really love some time to think about this. Or, you know, I really have to go and do some writing. I can't come to that office happy hour. Some of us feel, and I feel this all the time, the minute we're in a vaguely social situation at work or we need to collaborate or be with people and it makes us feel like we're overstretched or overstimulated, like we're in sixth grade again, right? Like we're walking into the cafeteria in middle school and no one wants to sit with us. Or, oh my God, people will think that I'm you know what, they won't think I'm a good person. They won't want to hang out with me. They won't like me. You're a grown-up. You are allowed to create the boundaries that allow you to do your best work. And then also, sometimes you'll know when you do need to get out there, when you do need to go to that happy hour, when you do need to have that FaceTime and go to the meeting. It's not a binary situation, but it's always okay to know your boundaries and to set good limits, like taking the time you need and taking the space you need to do your best job.